Hey guys, hi. This video is related to my travel. We are the third country from Delhi to Toronto. And this third country is different, which nobody have heard about it. And it's a new experience. It's by Albania. It's a country in Europe. So I'm going to tell you and share you my experience. See, I don't have any channel. I don't have any page where I wanted to subscribe you for me for or something. It's just a helpful video so that you people can find that there is another way as well where you can travel through. And yes, I have managed to travel to Albania. Okay, so journey eventually started that I bought a flight on 5th of July from Delhi. Actually, there are flights from Delhi to direct to Frankfurt. But what I did, my flight from Delhi to Bombay, then Bombay to Frankfurt and Frankfurt to Albania. So it was all done by Lufthansa Airlines, where Lufthansa had provided me the packages of two baggages, okay, and plus the cabin was also been there and things were arranged accordingly. So I bought a flight to Bombay, although I can get it from Delhi as well, but I wanted to fly early. So I just asked my agent to get it done me as early as dates as possible. So on 5th, I just bought the flight to Bombay. And then from Bombay, I do have a 13 hours of layover at Bombay airport. Sorry, not 13 hours. I do have a layover around, yeah, it was like kind of a 10 hours or something of layover. And then at night, around 2, I had a flight to Frankfurt. Then Frankfurt, I reached there, Frankfurt, in 5-8 hours or something. And then I had a layover again there of 13 hours. And then I had a flight to Albania. And that flight was around, the duration of the flight was 2.5 hours. So I went there. I must tell you the people that Albania is very peaceful city and it's very amazing. It's very welcoming country and people are very friendly over there. I didn't need any visa. Indian passport holders doesn't need any visa to travel to Albania. I booked my RT-PCR test done and it was done there. It is outside the airport where I got it done and you'll get the result in 90 minutes. Actually, it happened that you get the results in 90 minutes. So there I got the test done. Okay, I reached there at night around 11:30 or something, and then I got my RT-PCR done. In the morning, my agent, traveler has arranged, like my travel agent has arranged, the person who was there took me and to the RT-PCR test and everything. He came there to fetch me off from the airport and he arranged everything for me. So got the test done and he sent the reports to the hotel where I was staying at the reception and collected. So it is quite smooth. The immigration people are really smooth. Actually, I must tell you that this is new to them that Indians are traveling to Albania because people haven't traveled there. Okay, now Serbia route is very popular. Like people are frequently traveling to Serbia, but Albania is still not been that popular. But I must tell you that you should opt for Albania and it's very good rate. Albania is perfectly good way for you to travel and explore. I stayed there for 2 days, although I can board a flight. Like when I got the test done at night, I could board the flight very next morning, but I didn't do that. And the purpose of that I wanted to stay there for 2 days. I want to enjoy the city. I roamed around. I went to the Skanderborg Square. I went to the Great Museum of Albania, the Albanian University, the Great International Library of Albania, and the Frankfurt Bank Church, which is all near, like probably 25 or 35 kilometer of walking. Like I did that and I explored to the very good destinations of Albania and I was feeling amazing over there. You don't need anything. They are like, this is new to them. Just tell them that you wanted to get the RT-PCR done at the immigrations and just that. Okay, then from there I bought the flight on 8th. Yeah, I reached there by 6th July and I was stayed there for 2 nights and I bought the flight on 8th. 8th was like 6:15 was the flight and that flight was from, I'm still telling you of the Lufthansa airline, that flight was from Albania to Frankfurt and Frankfurt to Toronto. In Frankfurt, I had a layover of 1.5 hours or 2 hours probably. So guys, you have to make it really rush. They're gonna take their check-in bags and everything and they're gonna give you at Toronto airport. So Lufthansa, and it was operated by Air Canada. So things were like, you'll get the 2 ways of it. Okay, might be there's a possibility that you can get both the flights of Lufthansa. So you'll get the 2 boarding passes at Albania airport, international airport, Tirana. Okay, but if you don't panic. You'll get another one at the Frankfurt airport, which I got it eventually because it was operated by Air Canada. So I reached there Now the problem is there with me. What happened that I didn't have the boarding pass because I told you. So for boarding pass, they're gonna tell you that you have to reach there at the place where the gate you have to board the flight. Over there, they have made every provision for the Indian passport holders. You have to show your RT-PCR test, which should be within the duration of 72 hours. They'll check your RT-PCR. They'll check your vaccines also. They will check your, visa, study visa for Canada, and they will give you the boarding pass. Take care. Just be sure that your RT-PCR is ready with you. They'll give you a boarding pass as when the flight, and then my flight just bought, and I reached Toronto approximately 9 hours duration. Yeah, I reached there. Now, the actual struggle which gonna hit everybody mind is what happened at the immigrations. Guys, immigration was quite smooth. But I must tell you that they have actually changed the ways now. For immigrations, previously you guys have to might be getting the immigration quite soon. But now they are divided in two. First, you have to go to the receipt center. At the receipt center, there is a machine. You have to fill the Arrive Canada form, which you will be provided at the flights. That exact form needs to be formed. Arrive Can is different. Arrive Canada, there another kind of form they'll provide you at the airlines. That the same you have to fill in that machine, you'll get a receipt. Now this receipt is the major thing. Okay, I don't have the receipt to show it to you because it needs to be forwarded, but I have a picture. If you guys want, I can send the picture to you to have a look at it. Okay, that picture is that receipt is very important. Now the first entry point comes for the immigration. At the immigration, the officer is gonna ask you opening your Arrive Can receipt, which you do might be having when you get the RT-PCR. I get the RT-PCR. Sorry about that. In Albania, where I got the RT-PCR done, when I got the report, I uploaded all the documents on Arrive Can app. Okay, Arrive Can app is really smooth. Guys, don't panic while accessing that. It's very smooth. Just follow the processes, you'll get to know. So at the immigration of Canada, people are actually have their your receipt with them. They're gonna open everything on the screen. Now they'll be asking you questions on the basis what you have filled in the Arrive Can app. Okay, that process actually took 15 to 20 minutes for their cross questions. So be prepared for what you have filled. You should know what to be done. Like the questions, where you're staying in Canada, have you got fully vaccinated? They have made different cues for you to follow. Fully vaccinated, bifurcated. Single dose is bifurcated. If you are double dose but not Covishield, you're not vaccinated according to them. Different passport hold, different cues. So you have to follow accordingly. I was fully vaccinated. They asked the questions according to the Arrive Can app. I provided all the things to them, what has been required, right? The questions, where I'll be staying after quarantine, and if they approve my certificates, you need to get your quarantine plan ready. Okay, for 14 days full-fledged, 3 days at the mandatory, and then they're gonna refund you back. Even the hotel gonna refund you, and or college or anywhere you have done it, because it is required at immigration. They're gonna ask for that. Cool. So and eventually then I answer their questions. Then they even ask that what's your way through which you are coming. They knew it that we are coming through Albania, but still they wanted to ask you. They're gonna ask questions related to that why you stayed in Albania, why you choose this way, then all these questions. At the moment, they'll be just assisting your Arrive Can app. Are you place where you've been vaccinated? They're gonna ask the dates, the place where you are vaccinated, and your dates, first dose and second dose. Okay, then eventually you will get this is if you are fully vaccinated, you will get this sticker, and this sticker means that you don't need to quarantine at all. So I was fully vaccinated by AstraZeneca, which was under Covishield. So I got this sticker on my passport. So then I got released, and now I can move ahead. Now the phase comes with the second immigration process, where you need to get your study permit with you. Guys, this is really big thing, because here you need to crack the second session, and second session was way too tough. I was queued. There were long queues there for the study permit, to get your study permit, and people were struggling. I could see that. They were taking approximately 45 to 1 hour to take an interview of a single person. I must tell you an example. There were guys in front of me, in the queue where I was there. There were guys. They were asking, throwing questions, shooting the questions on them, why you are here, why you wanted to be here, like why you choose this way, why should we give you this immigrate, why should we clear all the things with you. And they were asking for the documents, the schedule, your grades of a previous semester, then are you attending the lectures, what time did you attend the lectures lastly, then when your orientation, like out of the blues questions. Also they're asking your IELTS academic sheet, your scores, your letter of acceptance, port of entry they're asking, your ICCR letter they're asking. They're even asking for, what do you say, that grades what you have got, they want to proof of it. So they're taking. So guys, at that moment, people were panicking. They didn't knew what to answer. Like, there was a guy from Centennial, he actually didn't manage to answer. His course was for 1 year. He was into supply chain. His course was for 1 year. And there were only 2 months left. At 15th August, his course is going to be end. So there he got into a trick. The lady asked that, why you are here when your course is going to be ended? You have done 80% of your course in India. So why you are coming to Canada all the way? And there he got panicked. He said that, after this, I'm going to have co-op. And she then said that, I want to see your papers ready to co-op. And he doesn't have it. Then she said that, show me the documents where it's written that you have a co-op with your course attend. And there he again fling with it. He was not able to reply back. At the moment, she just stopped him and asked him that you have to sit at the back. You are not being permitted for study permit. I'm going to take you to my higher officers. Then they're going to decide what happened. Guys, trust me. Questions are really very simple. But they look at the way you express them. They look at the way you interact with them. How confident are you? Are you able to tackle? They look at your facial expression, your eyes, your eye contact while talking to them. So be very confident while talking to them, okay? Then, also I got an example of a girl who struggled. She was missing with one of the document. Okay, I don't know, because I can look at these questions because people were, those who were in front of me, you can really clearly hear that what all questions are being there with them, what they are being asking them. Okay, then she missed with the questions, plus she missed one document, they deported her back. You're not allowed, deport her. Deport section was different, and they are actually doing it. I have seen this personally in front of me. I don't know the girl's name, I don't know from which college she was, but she was deported back. And I think she was from Punjab, because I can judge her accent, the way she was talking. So she was from Punjab and she was deported back. Guys, be there, be attentive. You need to. They're taking 45 to 1 hour. Eventually, when my chance came, I answered the question. They asked me 3 questions. Why you are coming here? What's the reason you wanted to study? And they asked you, how long is your course? Okay, like the time period. I answered all the questions and I was confident enough. And they asked me that, show me your documents. And the document, letter of acceptance, your quarantine plan, then your previous semester grades, your timetable, port of entry. Another was fee receipt. Don't forget to get your fee receipt done. Okay, all these documents and IELTS scorecard. All these documents club together, show it to them, and it's done. I got my study permit within 10 minutes. Just 10 minutes, I got my study. I forgot to take my, bring my study permit, otherwise I would have shown you. I got free in 10 minutes, I was released. At that moment, I asked them, ma'am, whether I need the quarantine or not. She said, you don't need any quarantine, you're free, you got this sticker. This means that you know quarantine for you. So you're free, you can move out. Now I was released, I was fine, I was super happy, and then eventually I went out, and there I met, they got a registration app with them for COVID test. They're doing the rapid COVID test, and there is an app portal which has been there. I can share you which portal it is. Okay, if you're gonna text me, I'll share you the portal. You have to do your registration there. With that registration only, you will get the COVID test done there. Okay, they are people, they're gonna help you at the airport for that app. Don't worry, but if you want in the privacy, you can ask me. Okay, so then they take my I had with my COVID test done, and things gonna be fine, and I released. Now you remember I talked about that slip from the machine. What happened at that slip? They're gonna put the crosses to 11 days and then 2 to 3 days. That means 14 days you don't need anything. That slip, now when you're doing the exit, collecting your baggage and everything, you need to submit that slip to them. That means now, at the time that, like, we booked the hotel for holiday inn, which our college has proved that, okay, Loyalist College, they said that you have booked holiday inn, you know. Now they, this slip, your, this passport number, everything, they will match up and I extended that. I said I'm in quarantine. They confirmed it, and then they said that we're gonna refund you back within 8 to 12 days once we get the confirmation from the Public Health of Canada. What's the thing is, so even for the 11 days, then eventually things did happen with me, and I'm super good. Even I got the text from a college, and they said that send me like where you're telling when you are, like what are the symptoms. And then I told them that I'm being exempted. They said that you need me. I send the picture of this, and also that's a sheet which I said that I had a click. Eventually I had a click, but because I summarized and I sent it to them, and they said okay, you don't need, and they're gonna refund my back to my account for that. So guys, it is easy process, it is smooth. Don't panic, be alerted, and things gonna be working with you. They just notice the way you talk to them. I'm telling you guys, things were really smooth for me. All immigrations were smooth for me. The last one, which I told you, taking a 45 to 1 hour, I was quite thinking that I was nervous, I was stressed. I think I don't know what's gonna happen, but that was actually an interview. When you're gonna face your employer, then you have to give an interview, right? It should be smoothing, it should be calm, it should be a big smile on your face. Whether he's stressed, whether she's stressed, might be upset, or might be like a kind of a thing frustrated from the candidates which were previous, but you need to give them something new. Okay, you need to show them that you're different from others. Then it's done. Thank you. I hope things gonna be fine with you, and I hope, I welcome that each one of you can probably enter Canada as soon as possible like I did. Give it a time. Things are risky, but things gonna work out. I managed this whole trip within the cost of 2 lakh rupees. This whole trip was done with 2 lakh rupees. Okay, I'm going to tell you my agent through which, if you people want it, I'm going to share you the details of my agent through which I manage this. Okay, so that's it. Bye-bye, guys, and be safe. And I hope to welcome and see you people all soon in Canada. Bye-bye.